subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India celebrates a number of festivals which have their roots embedded in ancient culture and history of the country. Losar festival, whose origin dates back to 15th century, is one among them. Though observed with great fervor and enthusiasm every year, this time the festival was kept a low-key affair due to the pandemic. Have a look.
Nestled between the great Himalayas and Karakoram mountain ranges lies the magical mountain kingdom of Ladakh. This Buddhist land, more akin to Tibet, has a centuries-old culture that finds its expression in festivals that are often the highlight of the year. Losar Festival, which is celebrated to ward off the evil spirits and mark the beginning of Buddhist New Year, is observed with much enthusiasm in the Union Territory. Many popular dishes and drinks are prepared during this festival, like the chang, a kind of beverage, and the kapsi, a cake. Held in the 11th month of Tibetan calendar, the festival lasts for 15 days, during which the religious places, including monasteries and residential houses, are illuminated and people visit the near and dear ones.
आज हमारे लद्दाखी लोसर है. लद्दाखी लोसर के अवसर पर मैं अब सबको शुभकामना देना चाहती हूँ. हैप्पी लोसर. तो मैं यही कामना करती हूँ, यही दुआ करती हूँ कि आने वाला साल हम सब के लिए अच्छा होगा, अमन होगा, शांति होगा, तो हम सब इस कोरोना से आज़ाद होगा. तो इस उम्मीद के साथ मैं एक बार फिर अब सबको हैप्पी लोसर.
This year, the festival was organized by the youth wing of Ladakh Buddhist Association. It made a symbolic celebration that began by offering prayers to Lord Buddha. Following it was the ceremony of unfurling the sacred Buddhist prayer flag Tarchan amidst ritualistic chanting before a small gathering in Chokhang Vihar in Leh. Every year, the festival is celebrated with great pomp and show, where humorous events of deer dance and amusing battles between the king and his ministers are performed. However, this year, due to the coronavirus outbreak, authorities decided to keep the festival celebrations a low-key affair.
हम सबको पता है कि last year हम यहाँ पे बहुत बड़े फंक्शन होते थे चोखांग वगैरह में. इस साल नहीं मना सका क्योंकि जो हमारे जो पुराने साल है उसमें हमको कोविड की वजह से हम सब लॉकडाउन रहा. तो इस बार हमको जो लोसर है इस तरह से जो बड़े धूमधाम से मनाते थे लेकिन इस बार नहीं मना सका. तो आने वाले नए साल में हम उम्मीद रखते हैं कि ये नए साल लद्दाखियों के लिए बहुत ही शुभ और स्पेशियस हो. तो इस पे मुबारक दिन पे मैं पूरा लद्दाख के निवासियों से को लोसर मुबारक.
In Ladakh, Losar festival is regarded as one of the most important socio-religious festival events. It started as a tradition during the supremacy of the 9th king of Tibet in the early 17th century when King Jamyang Namgyal decided to lead a war against the Baltistan forces in winter and ended up celebrating the festival in advance. people believe that the festival helps in strengthening ties between different communities, as it is usual for the Muslims and Christians of the region to visit their Buddhist friends and greet them on the occasion of the grand Mitho ceremony that takes place on the last evening of Losar.
When it comes to ensuring communal harmony in the country, a number of institutions and individuals pool in all their efforts. The Indian Armed Forces are one such contributor to the cause that keep on taking a number of steps to ensure that peace prevails in the nation. Their recent initiative, Qaumi Ekta Meet, that was organized in Rajouri district of Jammu and Kashmir, was yet another beautiful example of promoting religious unity.
Tune of communal harmony reverberated across Rajouri's Kalakot area as it hosted the Qaumi Ekta Meet. Organized by the Indian Army, the event saw a participation of religious leaders of all communities who came together at one platform to promote the message of harmony in the society. They even praised the army for doing a number of social works and serving people, especially during natural calamities.
हम चाहते हैं कि जाति मजहब से हटकर और कार्य किया जाए जैसे भारतीय सेना एक उदाहरण है उदाहरण के रूप में आज देखते हैं भारतीय सेना बहुत बड़े बड़े कार्य कर रही है जैसे कि आप देख रहे हैं कि मेडिकल कैंप लगाना समाज सेवा इत्यादि में तत्पर रहती है पीछे जो कोरोना के दौर में भारतीय सेना ने राशन बांटने का और कंबल बांटने का काम भी किया है और हर जगह पर बाढ़ आती है तो भारतीय सेना तत्पर रहती है
भारतीय सेना का जैसे हमने पहले ही कहा कि इनका बहुत बड़ा योगदान है यहाँ पर जो समाज को इकट्ठा रखने में इत्तफाक रखने में इत्तेहाद रखने में इन्होंने बहुत बड़ा किरदार अदा किया है
अमन की ज्योत जलाई जिसने सारे ही संसार में बांध लिया था हर प्राणी को उसने अपने प्यार में
The initiative was undertaken under Operation Sadbhavna in Kalakot as well as in surrounding areas. The highlight of the event was a short play based on religious harmony conducted by a theatre group from Jammu University. During the gathering, religious leader also encouraged the youngsters to foster and reinforce religious harmony and nationalistic fervor to strengthen the bond amongst people of all communities.
कभी भी धर्म हमें आपस में बयान नहीं सिखाता कि सब धर्म गुरुओं को सूचित किया जाता है सुनित किया जाता है कि वह दूसरे के धर्मों के साथ में अपने धर्म की भी रक्षा करें और दूसरे के धर्म का भी सम्मान करें
Since ages, Indians have lived together with peace and harmony, and events like these have contributed a lot in giving boost to this camaraderie.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Indian Space Agency, the Indian Space Research Organization, launched a communication satellite CMS-01 into its intended orbit from a space station off Sriharikota. The Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle C-50 carrying CMS-01 lifted off from the Satish Dhawan Space Center.
I am extremely happy to declare that PSLV C-50 successfully injected CMS-01, the communication satellite, in precisely in the predefined sub-GTO orbit. The satellite is functioning very well.
CMS-01 is India's 42nd communication satellite and will replace the GSAT-12 satellite launched in 2011. It will help in providing services in extended C-band of the frequency spectrum, and the coverage will include the Indian mainland, Andaman and Nicobar and Lakshadweep Islands. A houseboat owner, Tariq Ahmed Patlu, in Srinagar area of Jammu and Kashmir, has decided to convert his boat into the region's first water ambulance in a bid to help patients to reach the hospital at the earliest. Patlu got this idea when he tested positive for COVID-19 and found it difficult to reach the hospital via road. At that time, Patlu's friend lent him his boat and his life could be saved. Later, he decided to construct a water ambulance that will help patients reach the hospital on time.
इसकी हमें बहुत ज़रूरत है क्योंकि लोग बहुत खुश हैं कि अब मुझे हर एक और कोने में जाना है जहाँ पे ये सड़क नहीं है कुछ नहीं है वहाँ तक जो इमरजेंसी जहाँ पे कहीं पे भी कोई पेशेंट बीमार हो इसके ऊपर नंबर भी हम लिखेंगे टोल फ्री नंबर लगेगा इसके अंदर पूरा हर एक जहाँ पे भी डल लेक के अंदर किसी को कोई प्रॉब्लम हो तो वो खाली कॉल करेंगे तो उनको एम्बुलेंस वहीं पर डॉक्टर उनके घर पहुँचेगा.
Currently, the ambulance is at an under-construction stage and will soon begin the operations on the lake. And Patlu is confident that his initiative will help save dozens of lives in the valley. Authorities in Gujarat are renovating the famous Somnath Temple by installing gold plates on the urns of the temple. The big dome of the temple has urns made of stones which have got damaged due to poor weather. In place of these urns, the one made of copper will be installed and they will further be plated with gold, making the temple appear more attractive. Somnath Temple is an important pilgrimage and tourist spot of India. It is one among the 12 Jyotirlings of Lord Shiva in India and is believed to hold the first Jyotirling or representation of Lord Shiva.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at dargahs of Sufi saints. So today, we take you to the dargah of Qutbuddin Bakhtiar Kaki in New Delhi that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities for years. Take a look. Beautifully decorated with lights and reverberating with the sound of spellbinding qawwalis, the dargah of Qutbuddin Bakhtiar Kaki in New Delhi is an epicenter of religious harmony. Regarded as one of the oldest dargah in the city, it is thronged by the people of various faiths who come to pay their obeisance to the Sufi saint. The dargah is connected by a complex network of passageways passing through decorative arched gateways leading to large open courtyards. Devotees say that they experience a lot of peace here and the saint fulfills all their wishes.
यहाँ पर जैसे अपनी फैमिली के लिए हम कुछ मांगते हैं वो पूरा होता है जैसे कि हमें कोई भी प्रॉब्लम होती है मन की शांति के लिए है ये दरगाह और यहाँ से जब हम कहीं आते हैं कहीं से यहाँ इस दरगाह पे आते हैं तो यहाँ पर एक अच्छा सा महसूस होता है बहुत अच्छा सा फील होता है यहाँ पर.
Born born in 1173 in a small town called Osh in Kyrgyzstan, Qutbuddin Bakhtiar Kaki was a Muslim Sufi mystic and the disciple and spiritual successor of Moinuddin Chishti. He played a major role in establishing the Chishti order in Delhi, as earlier it was just confined to Ajmer and Nagaur. Today, his shrine also serves as the venue of the annual Phool Walon Ki Sair, an important interfaith festival of Delhi. Well recognized for spreading the message of love and brotherhood, the saint is revered by the people of all communities.
Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, सब आपस में भाई का नारा को इन्होंने बुलंद किया है और उसकी बय्यन सबूत ये है कि आज भी इनकी चौखट पे चाहे वो किसी तबके के हों, किसी मकतबे फिक्र के हों, चाहे किसी भी धर्म और मजहब के हों, सब लोग आते हैं और सब लोग फैजियाब होके जाते हैं.
For the last several years, the Dargah of Qutbuddin Bakhtiar Kaki has been playing a key role in strengthening secularism and promoting harmony amongst all religions. Christmas fever has taken everyone in its grip. Markets are flooded with Christmas trees, jingle bells, Santa masks, cards and so many other things, making a unique display altogether. But catching the fancy of visitors are the cake exhibitions set up across various parts of the country. So today, let's get tugged into a yummy experience by visiting the two popular cake exhibitions.
For those who have been admiring the beauty of the Leaning Tower of Pisa should surely have a glance at this beautiful replica of the wonderful building at Bengaluru's annual cake show. Organized by the Sugar Sculpt Academy, Bengaluru, the exhibition featured some uniquely themed cakes. Apart from the Leaning Tower of Pisa cake, replica cakes of Lion King's Pride Rock and Lord Nataraj were some cakes that caught major attention of the visitors, especially kids.
This time, apart from COVID awareness, we have made the maximum of the cakes for the kids. You know that very well, last 7 to 8 months, the kids are locked in inside the home and they're going for the online classes. And so many fluctuations are there. So that is the reason, like, you know, to come out from the so many problems. So we want to give a visual treat to the kids. So that is the reason mainly we made all the cakes maximum. See, if you see, we have made a Tom and Jerry and Doraemon and Chinese dragon for them, and even for the what is that, Osman is there, half human half us is there, and the main attractions were like Lion King is there and Pisa, Leaning Tower of Pisa is there, main attractions.
The coronavirus cake, Tom and Jerry cake, Eiffel Tower and the golden dragon were also at display. Visitors admired the intricate work and efforts behind the creation of the cakes and appreciated the fact that all safety measures were taken during the pandemic.
No, so cake show is something which is very creative, and that's why it's good for children. So that's why I got my daughter. Better than going into a closed place, it's better to come here. More sanitized, more safe. So everybody's taking around, it's better to come here. Sanitation is kept quite strict over here. Everybody has to pay or take a ticket and come inside, so people are also careful. And then I'm seeing that the security is also tight. They're asking people to wear masks, not to remove masks, so it's a very good outing.
Not just Bengaluru, but even the city of Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu got to witness one such delectable cake exhibition that attracted a number of visitors. The exhibition displayed a total of 30 mouth-watering cakes like Barbie, Flamingo and Santa Claus, and many other cakes of different colors, shapes and sizes. Special focus was laid on a coronavirus-themed cake with a motive of spreading awareness regarding the deadly virus among the general public. Visitors seemed excited as they went around looking in awe at the different varieties of cake designs in front of them.
There are lots of variety of cake and fondant displayed here. It is very beautiful to see. The little minute and tiny handmade works, it is very beautiful to see. There are many varieties of cakes like the Barbie doll theme, especially the Corona theme, which is a most global top around the world because the Corona is the trending one this year, we all know. So it is very beautiful. It creates awareness cake. This cake is awareness cake and I like that.
Cakes are an important delicacy in the Christmas feast. Every year, people eagerly wait to taste cakes with new and exciting themes. Thus, having such cake exhibitions during the Christmas time can serve a great way in reaching up to the expectations of the food connoisseurs.
Last but not the least, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia in our new edition, Asia in Focus.
With an aim to revolutionize access to clean water and better hygiene, a Japanese-based startup Water Corp has come up with a unique initiative enabling shoppers to wash their hands and sterilize their smartphones. These machines do not require any connection to running water and recycle the water through a three-stage process of membrane filtration, chlorine, and deep ultraviolet radiation. On an average, 20 liters of water can provide around 500 washes and the filters can be changed after 2000 washes.
銀座実は毎年本当は10回ぐらいイベントをやってるんですけども、今年は一つもできてないんですね。で、その人を集めるんじゃなくて、この街が来るのは大丈夫だよって安心して来られるところなんだっていうことを強調するために、できるだけ清潔感を出すっていうのがこのイベントの狙いです。
Bosch also has built-in device that cleans smartphones using 20 to 30 seconds of ultraviolet light exposure, the time it takes to thoroughly wash your hands. Water has now begun shipments within Japan of roughly 4,000 units. A Catholic church in Indonesia has decorated a Christmas tree with protective masks and hand sanitizers so as a way to spread awareness of COVID-19 in the festive season. Starting with a bamboo skeleton, the church's followers and the local Muslim community decorated the tree with hundreds of colorful donated masks and sanitizers and took a week to complete the 3-meter tree. Christmas is a public holiday in Indonesia, which has the world's largest Muslim population, but is only celebrated by around 10% of its 270 million people. Sitting in gondolas, moviegoers in the Philippine capital, Manila, are enjoying films while keeping safe amid the coronavirus pandemic. The Venice Grand Canal set up a screen in an outdoor canal of the upscale mall earlier in December and started showing films for those who missed the big screen as theaters have been closed since mid-March to stop the spread of the virus. The gondolas hold two people and are steered into place by gondoliers in traditional costumes before the movie starts. Umbrellas are provided in case of light showers.
Parang very unique experience siya. Kasi even before pa nung quarantine, wala namang ganitong instance na parang you can watch something parang outdoors saka parang in a canal or something like that. So gusto lang namin siya ma-experience.
There are only two screenings per day and most of the films are romantic dramas to match the mood of the outdoor cinema. A maximum of 10 people are allowed per screening and the tickets are sold online. For additional safety, Guests use their own earphones to listen to the movie audio by tuning into specific radio frequency.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.